Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple anvil in a very useful mechanical tool in SolidWorks. Many mechanical works we are doing manually with the help of anvil or on the anvil, especially the smithing work. So I hope you like it. Let's see how to do this in SolidWorks with the help of feature and sketch tool. So let's see. So here let's make the anvil. So start here, choose front plane, sketch. Let's choose here center rectangle and start from origin point. Right click, exit. Choose here smart dimension and keep make the distance dimension 8 by 12 inch. Okay, now select here 3-point arc. Connect one end to this end. Exit. Choose here trim entities, power trim, and delete this. Just make it undo. Again choose trim and select here trim to closest. That's it. Okay. Now select both the end lines and define relation equal. Okay, now let's make the dimension 1.456 inch. Okay, draw one vertical line, choose here mirror entity and mirror this line, this curve against vertical line. Okay, now let's define some angle. Some radius, let's say 8 inch. Choose your trim and we will trim this corner also. Okay, now it's time to extrude. So select here extruded boss and keep the dimension 2 inch only. Okay, now let's define the raw material. Choose here rough steel. Anvil always in a rough steel, the shape always looks like rough steel. So we will do it like this. Choose front plane, and create one plane above the, we will make above the 7.5 mm. Okay. Now select this plane one, sketch, choose here center rectangle and draw a rectangle. Right click and exit. Now let's define, keep the horizontal length 5 mm and vertical length we will say 7 mm. Okay. Now exit. Now hide the plane one. Now here we want to create two tapered plane. So let's see how to do this. Select here plane. First select this edge. Then select this edge. See a plane in tapered position. Okay. Again select one more plane. The same way select this edge and this edge. Okay, that's it. So now let's start. You can start anyone. Let's start plane 2, sketch. Okay, this is the perfect position. This is the plane 2. Now here choose. Now here we will do one, we will create some geometry. So choose here 3-point arc. Select this corner to this corner and take it inside. Okay, let's define the angle radius 12 mm. Okay, again choose and select this corner to be here. Exit. Now select both the arcs and make equal. Okay. Now draw one center line so that we will mirror it. Choose mirror, select both the lines and mirror against this center line. Okay. Now you can see here. Exit. Now plane 2 hide. Now select plane 3, sketch. Again choose here 3-point arc. Now this time we have to connect from this point to this point. Choose the smart dimension and define the radius same 12 inch, and let's keep the both and select equal. It should be merge here. Center line. Choose here mirror entity and select both the points and mirror against construction line or horizontal line. Exit. Now hide this plane. Now this is our geometry. Now it's time to develop a body, a solid body. So here we will select lofted boss base. First select this face and this geometry. Okay. Now go to curve, and it's time to select each and every curve. Select here open loop. Okay. Second one open loop. Okay. Now let's come to here open loop. All 8 corners we have to select. I think this one. Let's say this one. Open loop. Open loop. Now here the last one balance. Let's first choose inside. Open loop. And this one. Select here open loop. Okay. Now this is the our geometry going to be create. Okay, that's it. See, this is what the geometry we want. Now select this face sketch and we want to extrude up to 1 inch. So first select here convert entities. Now go to feature extruded boss and extrude up to 1 inch only. That's it. Now let's create one plane. First select this face and keep 5.5 inch. Okay. Now select this plane 4 sketch, take a position and here choose center rectangle. Draw one rectangle up to this outer edge. Exit. And let's say 5 mm width. Now exit. Now just hide this plane 4 so that geometry will be very clear. Now select this face sketch normal 3-point arc and connect from this point to this point. Take it out. Delete. Again try. Connect both the end points. exit, select this point and this point, coincide. Okay, now let's define this also 18 inch radius. This is also going out, so select both the endpoints, merge correlation. See, that's it. Exit. Now the same thing we will create here. Sketch 3-point arc, connect this point to this point. Exit. Now it's time to define 18 inch the radius, and here also the same 18 inch. Now this geometry also finished, so exit. Now it's time to develop the body, solid body. The same procedure, lofted boss base, select this base and this geometry. Now here in guided curves, choose this option, open. You have to select all the corners, open. Now see, okay, so this is our main body. Now here we will split this two faces to just look real view. Sketch, connect this end to this end. Exit and select here a split line and select this surface. Okay, keep projection. Now this is split two faces. Now here also we want to split it. Sketch, select here line and select both the ends, right click, exit, split line, select the face, projection. Okay, now this is also split. Now we want to create the horn for anvil, the one face we called horn. So let's make one plane first. Choose here top plane, plane 16 inch reverse direction. Okay, now select this plane 6. Sketch, let me draw one line, right click and exit. Choose here spline, connect from here to midpoint, bottom midpoint to end point. Exit, smart dimension and define the center distance 2.75 inch. Now exit. Now we want to project these things to this surface. So here there is one option, select here project curve. Now this curve is selected, we want to project on this surface. So see, we selected and you can see the preview. Sketch on faces. Okay, now select here 3D sketch. Now select this sketch and convert entities. Now it is converted in line. Exit. Again choose this plane 6, sketch, take a position, and first we will make, we want to create here half circle. So first draw one vertical line, circle, and start from here to this point. Exit, select line, exit, choose stream entity and delete this half circle. Okay, now select, keep the radius 0.5 inch. Exit. Now here two geometry. Now it's time to connect both the points. So choose here lofted boss base, select this corner and this corner. Now you can see the horn body, you can see the preview here, select here, OK. Something clear. Now let's try. That's it. Now you can hide this plane and you can hide this also curve. So our body's horn is ready. This is called the horn for anvil. Now here you can see this is the first phase. We want to make a circular horn. So again we have to repeat the same thing. Just select the plane 6, sketch, take the position, line, exit. Choose here a spline and connect from here to this point, exit. Now let's define the gap 2.75 inch, exit. Now this curve we want to project here, so same procedure, select here project curve, sketch selected, just select the face, okay. Choose 3D sketch, select this curve, projected curve, and convert entities. Now it is converted. Exit. Now here select plane 6, sketch, take position, okay. Here you can see the previous one, so select circle and draw one circle, choose midpoint and select up to this corner, so it will be automatically 1 inch. Select line, connect from exit, choose trim entity and trim this half circle, okay. We need circle bottom, so just do one thing, trim, edit, undo, now trim and trim this upper one, okay. Now this perfect, exit and choose here sweep lofted boss base, clear, and select one end of this arc and the same here the one end of this arc, okay. That's it. Now you can see the horn body is ready. This is the horn for anvil. If you want you can hide it, this curve, so it looks real. That's it. Now we want to extend this face and we'll second end. So first select the top face, sketch, and draw here a triangle. Let's draw a vertical center line. Connect from this end to this end. Exit. Now choose the smart dimension, keep 10 inch, exit. Now select right plane, sketch, and select line and draw from this end, right click, exit, and define it 1.5 inch. Okay, it is coincident here. Now exit and choose here 3D sketch. 3D sketch, select line, connect from this point to this point, and at the end, exit. Now geometry is fully defined. Exit. Selected here lofted boss base, 3D sketch already selected, and select this upper triangle. In guided curve, choose this corner edges and this line. See? Okay. Now that's it. This is the extension of anvil body, because we need lot of space to do the hammer work. Now let's make the hardy hole and Pritchell, which is used for blacksmithing and many purpose. So select the top face, sketch, normal. Let me first draw a center line. Select here corner rectangle. Select 1 by 1 inch. And the distance, keep 1 inch. Okay, select here circle. Choose smart dimension and keep the diameter 1 inch and the distance from end point 1.5 inch. It is up to you. Now let's make this hole. This is specially used for blacksmithing or using for to create the horse's nail. Cancel it. Extrude cut. Keep 1 inch inside. Okay. So this is our anvil is ready for blacksmithing or many purpose. It is very useful tool. Select this face, sketch. Exit. Select this face line and here write CAD CAM tutorial med. That's it. Select 0.7 inch, but it's quite bigger. 0.5 inch. Okay. 0.5 inch is 0.6 inch. This is quite perfect. Bold. Okay. Now exit and select here wrap. Select this face and we want to choose emboss. ₹0.01. That's it. Define any color so that you will identify. So this is the anvil we made in SolidWorks with the help of many feature tools and sketch. I hope you like it. Please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. If you have any question, please write in comment box. Thanks for watching.